Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate a thermochemistry experiment that we can use to determine the enthalpy of fusion of ice. For this experiment, we're going to use water in two different forms: deionized water in its liquid form and deionized water in its solid form. And I have here an ice cube tray with many ice cubes in it. They have been on the countertop for a little while, and that is intentional because I would like my ice cubes to be as close as possible to 0 degrees Celsius, which is the melting point of ice. And just to make sure that I'm only using ice, I will use some paper towels to dab off any molten ice from them. For the experiment, because this is thermochemistry, we're going to need to track the mass of water in both of its forms. So we will need a scale. We will need to monitor the temperature of the water that we're using and the final temperature of the mixture of the two. And for that, we're going to use a thermometer. We will estimate the approximate volume of the ionized water for the experiment. So we will need a graduated cylinder. And as for all thermochemistry experiments, we need to keep any energy in the form of heat from the outside from interfering with the experiment. So we will need two nestled styrofoam cups and a cardboard lid on top. And here we have all our materials for this experiment. Let's begin. First, we're going to turn on our scale, place our styrofoam cups on top, tear it, transfer approximately 100 milliliters of deionized water in the graduated cylinder. We can record the volume, but the important thing here is that we know the mass of our deionized water. So in the graduated cylinder, I have 99.9 milliliters of deionized water. I will transfer this into the styrofoam cup, and I will add another approximately 50 milliliters of deionized water to it for a total of approximately 150 milliliters of combined deionized water. It is just a little bit over at 50.3 milliliters of water. I will pour this into the styrofoam cup as well. The combined mass of my deionized water is 147.75 grams. This is where I need to take my first temperature measurement. I will slide my thermometer inside the water. Give it approximately a minute, and then record my starting temperature for the deionized water. The starting temperature of my deionized water is 22.0 degrees Celsius. And whenever we record temperature using the typical thermometer, we will need to have one decimal place in that measurement. Next, we remove the thermometer, place our styrofoam cups with the water, and now we can add the cardboard lid on top. We're going to tear our measurement. Then we're going to extract our ice cube from the ice cube tray, dab it as dry as we can with our paper towel so that the heat that it will absorb from the deionized water, it will go directly to the melting of the ice cube and the warming of the molten ice. So for this experiment, we will need to know the mass of the ice. I have my styrofoam cup with the deionized water and the cardboard lid on the scale. I will tear it. And when it shows 0.00, I will very quickly remove the cardboard lid and slide in the ice cube. Then I will place the cardboard lid on top and record the mass of my ice cube. That is 19.93 grams. I am done collecting all the mass measurements. I know the mass of the deionized water that was added to the styrofoam cups, and I also know the mass of the ice that was added to the styrofoam cups. I know the temperature of my water at the beginning. I am going to assume that my ice cube was at 0 degrees Celsius because it was melting all over the ice cube tray which means it was very close to the melting point and some of it did melt. I just wiped it away with a paper towel. So now all that is left is for us to wait until the ice cube completely melts and records the final temperature of our water. It has been approximately 10 minutes of me tracking the temperature of my ice and water blend inside the cup, and my ice cube is now fully melted. It is time to record the final temperature of the water that's inside the cups. And the final temperature is 5.4 degrees Celsius. From this information, the mass of water, the mass of ice, the initial temperature of the water, and the final temperature of the ice and water combined, I should be able to determine the enthalpy of fusion of ice.